All right. Welcome to the brand new D&D series, Roll for Adventure. I am your DM, Eric Scott, and I'm here with Andy Tran.
I feel like I'm going to die via metal
You point. Might. Zach Little.
Hola.
Noah Richards. And Kevin Roman. And we have our wonderful tech crew behind the camera.
Patsy.
Yo.
All right, so we are going to be starting on Curse of Strahd, 5th edition.
Look at that guy in the cover.
I know, he's so smug.
He's handsome.
And we shall start out with introducing the characters who we will be following for the next many episodes and adventures. Who'd like to start? Who would like to share with the group?
Roll for who shares first.
Okay.
God damn it. Fuck. Roll for initiative!
9. Nope. 6.
I got you just volunteered, 2, you
3.
Dicks.
You rolled a... whatever.
I rolled 3 for... I got 5, but I had minus 2 initiative.
Andy goes first.
Okay, fine. I go first.
Okay, Andy, go.
My name is Yosberg
Pulse.
I'm a level 2 human paladin of Shantaea.
Okay.
Want me to say that again?
Yeah, say it again.
Okay.
You love.
My name is Dogsberg Hulks. I am a level 2 paladin of Shantaea.
Give us a little more description. Like, what does your guy look like?
Okay, we
need general description.
Okay, well, you know, I'm actually a pretty aged man, around late 40s, around there. I used to be part of a regiment known as Richter's Riders, but after taking an arrow to my shin, I met a nice lady, a nice priestess of Shantaea there, and I kind of was a bit smitten by her, so I kind of followed her back like a lost puppy all the way to Nutwood, which is where I live, basically kind of just helping other townsfolk, courting her, and all that fun stuff until I eventually got married to her, and then I became a paladin.
Alright, cool. Nutwood was, of course, the starting point for us.
Right next to Morningwood.
Yep, next to Morningwood, and in Branchwood, and all the other beautiful wood cities.
Wood-themed towns.
Alright, Zach, who are you?
Hi, my name is Ashton Spinari. I've been an alcoholic for about 3 years. I'm about in my early 20s. I go around in this neat little robe. It's pretty nice. I don't remember how I got it. I just kind of just inherited it.
It was in your closet.
It was in my closet, yeah.
He just got everything from his mother.
Yeah,
what's your class, buddy?
Mommy hand me down. I have a nice little bow and arrow with a, bow and arrow with 2 swords, or 2 mini swords, I should say, and, I have this 1 golden arrow that we found when we did
We'll get to that.
Yeah, we'll get to all that jazz, but yeah, I'm a half-elf. I speak Common, Elvish,
We don't need to know all the languages you speak, we just gotta get a general description of your character.
Yeah, that's the general description.
We don't need to know that you can speak to leprechauns, we're good.
I speak 4 languages, it's nice. I think that's pretty much all I could say about myself. I mean, do you want me to go into my background a bit, or what?
Black hair, pale skin, got a beard.
Yeah, black hair, got a little beard. I mean, I don't have it now because of work, but yeah.
All right, Krog.
Okay, so my name is Krog. I am 27 years old. I'm half orc, half human. My dad was an orc, and my mom was a human. So,
a nasty shock to her when she found out.
Grunch the Mangler.
So the orcs decided, you know what? Let's raid this one town.
Yeah, the orcs constantly raid Nutwood.
Yeah.
And they don't do a good job of it.
So
it was even worse when I came around.
Yeah.
So basically, my dad raided this one house that my mom was living in, and
a fight full of natural ones happened.
Yeah, and then all you know is that they had me, and now I'm beautiful, I have light gray hair.
He's beautiful.
No, you have black hair.
God damn, is he beautiful.
Light gray skin, very muscular, and
ridiculously muscular.
And yeah, that's pretty.
He's like, if you ever look up Arnold Schwarzenegger in his bodybuilding days, that's Krog. With the Conan hair.
With the Conan.
The only natural 20 is Conan's role was you.
Well, he'll show you his natural 20.
What?
Aecilius!
Our mage!
I am Aecilius. I am a tiefling. Been cursed all my life. So cursed that my parents were murdered when I was a child until I was found by my master. And then one day he disappeared as well. So now I travel with these idiots in hopes of searching for him.
Hey.
Your wizard master.
My wizard master.
You should mention that you're a wizard.
I am not a slave.
Traveling idiots.
You're a wizard, Eric.
You're me.
My skin is red, my eyes are gold, and I will kill anybody in my way.
You know, here's the backstory. Oh, yeah. Actually did sound a bit like Harry Potter in the beginning.
Except, well, there's no magical school. He just ended up in Nutwood.
No, I mean, like, think about, like, when he was a kid, his parents were killed by a girl, like, was cursed.
It was an angry mob.
Yeah.
Still. It was not the same. It was not Voldemort.
It wasn't Voldemort and the Death Eaters, yeah.
All right.
The mob was so messed up. He doesn't get it.
So, prior to this adventure, we did have a pre-adventure where we worked out the origin of these guys and got them up to level 2, in which they went to the next town, the neighboring town of Branchwood, to speak to Krog's uncle and basically take over the family circus. I'm sorry, I'm very burpy right now. Jesus, okay. In the ensuing fight, they found, among other things, a magical arrow that Ashton has, a golden and ebony arrow of amazing power that he does not know. They fought a bear, which they were able to knock out. They spared the bear, the circus bear that was attacking them. And then they ended up fighting Krog's uncle Kurgit, his imp, a belly dancing goblin, and an extremely sad clown named Gonzo.
Oh, man, Gonzo, man.
Whom the paladin Gosberg Holes proceeded to turn into pasta sauce.
It was a mercy kill.
That's going Gosberg.
He wanted to die, let's be honest.
It was a mercy kill.
He was a very sad clown.
Forgot to tell him
about ugly at you.
Oh, yes. And also, while they were in town, a little white mouse appeared to Gosberg and is now traveling with him. And it has a tiny red symbol on its back and a different shade of fur, red fur on its back, in the shape of his goddess, Shantaea.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll see what transpires as far as that goes. Other than that, the boys all got at least one magical goodie each.
Yep.
And now they are setting off on their adventure. Could be a traveling band of entertainers, or what's your other goals? You're looking for your master. Does anyone have any other goals?
Well, I'm not an entertainer, but I feel like after the whole thing with the mouse Aioli, I feel like I should keep traveling with these guys because the mouse seems to be a sign of my goddess. So I'm just gonna travel and hope something happens to tell me which way I should go next.
I guess I'm trying to avenge my mom. She was killed by a werewolf, so there's that.
All right, and you did see a man killed by a werewolf.
There was
last
that,
time,
yeah.
When you investigated. All right, you're...
This werewolf smells good.
My wish is the circus.
Yeah, his wish is the circus. He's gonna entertain people and acrobat around and play the clarinet. All right, so let's get started on this. Let me just open up this book. Small disclaimer, Wizards of the Coast cannot be held liable for any long-term side effects of venturing into the dread realm of Ravenloft, such as lycanthropy, vampirism, a fear of dead things, fear of living things, inability to sleep without a nightlight on, and a +5 Holy Avenger under your pillow. And the unsettling suspicion that Strahd is too clever to be so easily defeated, and that this is all just part of some grand scheme to extend his power beyond Barovia. You didn't think you could escape unless he wanted you to, did you? All right, let's start the game. So you guys have been out on the road.
Mm-hmm.
You're traveling. You've been out. You set up camp for the night. You had a campfire.
Like,
you had
all of our like.
Gather around the campfire.
With all of our circus equipment with us. Like, are we having like a?
You did not have wagons. Okay. You didn't have horses for any of that. Krog's grandfather would have sent people to take care of that, like he told you.
Krog's grandfather is like the OG.
Yeah, he was. He's an OG fella.
The original circus manager.
Yes, and you guys, you know, you were having a good time. You know, you're hanging out. You were talking about like, oh, did you see I did that last? You know, yeah, it was cool. And you know, Krog played his clarinet for you guys. You know, you warmed up. And then you went to sleep. And now you have awoken in the morning.
Woo!
And the first thing you notice are mists. It is very misty and very dark. The woods are quiet, and the air grows chill. Your fire sputters as a low mist gathers around the edges of your camp, growing closer as the night wears on, as the day wears on by. The fog hangs thick in the air, turning the trees around you into gray ghosts. Then you notice these are not the same trees that surrounded you the night before.
What? Ah, crap. Hey, fellas. I don't mean to alarm you, but I believe that that someone moved us. Or either that, or the trees moved themselves.
How is that even possible?
Ever heard of an Ent?
Well...
Killed a couple during the Human-Elf War.
I thought they were legends.
Nah, man, look, the last thing we need is an Ent. Okay?
Alright.
So are we gonna investigate?
Yes, as you step out and get a better look, you notice that there are shapes in the mist.
Oh, fuck,
the shapes of wolves.
Oh,
and dire wolves.
Ah, crap.
And as you look around, the four of you in this circle around your campfire, they are completely surrounding you.
The SpongeBob meme?
Draw circles!
When you wake up and there's shape-shifting mist around you.
Oh, the caveman SpongeBob thing.
Yeah.
You dumbasses. There are wolves completely surrounding you.
Oh, crap. Okay.
Just well, in the mists. But you first.
Can I attempt to speak with them since I have a thing like that?
Speak to animals.
Yeah.
Do you want to use a spell slot to speak to the wolves?
Sure. Well, let's put my spells to good use.
How many spell slots do you have out of curiosity?
I don't know.
Like two?
I think two, yeah.
You get two spells a day?
Yeah. Oh yeah, two spells.
Alright, this is gonna be one of your spells.
This is gonna be one of my spells. Alright, I need to roll a,
this one. You don't have to roll anything, you just cast the spell on yourself.
Alright, speaking to animals, Abadacadabra. Now they're all dead. Just kidding.
They exploded.
Hey, you cast an Abadacadabra about a wand, so that's pretty impressive.
I guess my thing is to realize that we mean them no harm. And we're just traveling.
How do you know they don't mean us harm?
Or, and then if we can go along our merry way, for favor.
The wolves just kind of stare at you and growl a lot. And, generally, like, you can see or hear some hubbub since you can actually speak with animals.
Mm-hmm.
You don't get all of it because there's a lot of wolves. But you generally get a few snippets like meat and hunt. And oh boy.
Be aware, we are armed and we will defend ourselves if you attempt to eat us.
Roll perception checks, if you will, actually.
2.
15.
I see dirt.
3.
I got
15.
Ah, shit! As you're a little more far out, and as you go out to speak with the wolves, you do notice, only for really a second, but it seems to be a human-like shape in the mists.
Oh.
And then it's gone.
It's gone?
Yeah, it disappears as soon as you saw it. didn't seem to be like moving. It just like
stood there for a second and like.
Yeah, you just caught a glimmer of a human shape, humanoid shape, and then.
Shit. She's an ent.
If these are your wolves, we have to please attract them.
The wolves are slowly moving forward.
Alright, bye.
Battle formations!
Alright, boys, I think it's about time we have to defend ourselves here.
Battle formations!
What do you guys do?
Can I detect magic to see what the hell what that was? Or is it gone?
You didn't see it.
Okay. So. Alright, I was looking at
dirt. Son of a bitch!
I got it too. I was looking at it.
Well, that's great dirt.
It's like, you know, this is some nice dirt for us to die on.
I wonder how deep we can dig this.
Ground bound by 6 feet under.
All right, boys, what do we do?
Battle formations!
Yeah, I'm gonna go with Gosberg here.
All right. As you guys all sort of go to...
Arrows out.
Ready your weapons. The wolves disappear into the mists. Ah. They kind of they run off.
I think me talking to work, fellas.
Okay. So, we're gonna stand like in a mob. We're standing like
a circle. Oh, you got your fingers?
Yeah, I'm still the owl.
Yes, you were Wobbuffet.
Yes.
You were the goat. Alright, cool.
Doge!
Roll. All right.
Charlie!
Let me get my map out here.
It's one of the wolves.
Look, okay.
Alright.
That's.
As you. The mists do clear a little bit.
Are these the trees?
It's yeah. Still very misty. Clouds are covering the sky. The sun is not shining. So but you do notice a dirt road that you can go down.
Let's follow the path, boys.
Yes.
Follow right. The brown dirt road.
As you're walking down this
arm
road,
in arms. Follow the brown brick road. Follow the brown brick road.
Brown, not even bricks.
Dirt brown dirt road.
Guys, I found a path.
Black pools of water stand like mirrors in and around the muddy roadway.
Coming back.
Giant trees loom on both sides of the road, their branches clawing at the mist.
Ah, fucking ants.
Ents do exist in D&D. They might have a slightly different name.
Treants.
Treants, I think, yes.
Andy, you're the spiky turtle thing, right?
Yeah, I'm the Ankylosaurus.
Spiky turtle thing.
Know your basic third grade dinosaurs.
After walking for about 15 minutes, the fog spills out of the forest to swallow up the road behind you.
Crap.
Ahead, jutting up from the impenetrable woods on both sides of the road, are high stone buttresses. Looming gray in the fog. Huge iron gates hang on the stonework. Dew clings with cold tenacity to the rusted bars. Two headless statues of armed guardians flank the gate, their heads now lying among the weeds at their feet. They greet you only with silence.
So what, they wave at us?
No, there's just two big old headless statues by a gate.
Damn. Well, at least it ain't ants.
Yeah.
So guys, shall we greet these statues? I'm gonna greet a statue. I'm gonna just wave awkwardly to the statue.
The statue does nothing.
Okay, cool.
It's a headless statue. Their heads are in the grass.
I just wanna know if these statues are gonna come up and wreck our shit or something. Cause I've had that happen, okay? I was in a war.
Can Noah check for magic?
Can I detect the magic?
Do you want to waste a spell slot to detect magic?
No, I don't. Or should I?
It's your call.
You have three spell slots.
Okay, I'll do it.
I only use one because I know I'm rarely going to use magic.
If I die, I die.
All right, you cast detect magic.
I saw that.
Right?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
Did Divine Sense cost magic? Cost a spell slot? I don't think so, right?
Divine Sense only can detect creatures and stuff, I think.
Okay.
Like evil beings.
Got it.
You detect kind of just a general magic around the place, but nothing about the statues. Mm-hmm. The statues are not going to come alive and kick your asses.
Okay.
You're good.
You're lying. I think you're lying.
I could.
You probably are.
I could do such if I wished.
They could be mechanical.
They could be.
You golem.
No, you're fine. There's no magic about the statues.
So the statues are headless and their heads are in the grass, right? Can I get into the grass?
You can go
you're
into the
standing
grass.
Standing in the grass.
Okay, we're standing on a dirt road.
You're on a dirt road, yes.
Okay, I'm gonna go. How heavy are these heads?
They're big old statues. They actually look like that.
Okay.
Oh shit.
Yeah, they're big ass statues.
Okay.
That's a lot bigger than I thought it was. But
yeah,
okay.
Same here.
This is a huge ass gate. Like.
So guys, should we greet ourselves to greet the, have the circus greet the gate guard?
I'm sorry. What?
There's a gate guard.
Oh, if there, well, there's a gate. There's probably gonna be a gate guard.
Isn't it abandoned?
You do not see any sign of life. This looks completely deep. Like there's no one there.
Okay.
I guess we only should not greet them though.
Yeah. Just go ahead and
all right, let's walk on through, boys.
All right.
Loot. No, let's loot.
Loot? Loot what?
We need to loot.
Are you taking the head with you?
He can do it. He's a Krog. He can pick up one of these fucking, like, 10-foot wide statue heads and just like, oh, I'm bringing this.
Send it to your dad. So your dad can have another
Send him another head.
Send him another head, yeah.
Whoa. Is your mom still alive? It to him. Is your mom? Is your mom still alive?
His mom is still alive. Yeah.
Send it to your mom.
Mail it to him. All right. As you walk towards the gates swing open slowly, screeching as they do so.
By themselves?
By themselves.
Oh, crap.
Someone needs to oil these gates here.
I know, right?
You walk through?
Walk through.
Walk through, yeah.
All right. You walk through the gates, and as soon as you guys have passed through the gates, they close behind you.
Hopefully these things open again.
We did.
How far is my divine sense?
I don't know. Look in the player's handbook, if you so wish, if you so desire.
Okay. I want to.
Ahead of you, you see yet more woods.
Well, apparently someone wanted to lock away the fucking ends. I am sticking with the end hatred, okay?
What do you have against ends?
Yeah, what the fuck, dude?
I fought in a war.
You forgot I live in the woods?
Okay. First you hate the elves.
You take everything so personally when you're playing a character.
I know, right?
Like, to the littlest things. I remember when you played a wizard, you're like, wizards aren't that bad because you're a wizard. Like, there are bad wizards.
That wizards are great. Let me, we have a wizard right here and he's awesome.
Do you hate me too?
No. Because you're not
you we don't, inside. Okay, what are you trying to
I'm
do?
I'm looking for a paladin. I think I'm
it's, keep going, okay. Behind Monk.
I just wanted to see if there's like anything around us that's doing all this crap, or is it all automatic?
Divine Sense is the next page, I believe.
Okay, Divine Sense, what is
it? Right there.
Okay, thank you. 60 feet, okay, I don't think I can.
60, let me see.
Yeah.
Alright, do you want to use Divine Sense? It's just kind of a general thing that you can use.
Okay, I'm just
doesn't
gonna
do anything.
I'm gonna use Divine Sense,
doesn't,
I guess,
doesn't
yeah.
cost in a spell slot.
I'll use Divine Sense, yeah.
Alright. You don't sense any particular strong evil.
Okay, cool. I just want to figure stuff out. So I can either detect creatures and stuff, though, right?
If they are... You would be able to detect evil creatures. And you can kind of feel like there are wolves about, like, and these wolves are registering as evil, but you don't particularly detect anything
too
powerful.
Okay.
No.
So there's wolves around us.
Yeah, those wolves have not left. They're
okay, I'm gonna tell you guys right now. I just use my divine sense and I sent in some e-wolves. It's strange because they're actually I'm registering them as evil, which is strange because animals tend to be rather neutral.
Are wolves usually evil?
Check this shit.
Is it?
I mean, yeah, the animals do tend to be neutral.
Yeah.
I didn't write that down. I did not write down the alignments of animals. I just wrote down their stats. Alright, as you guys continue forward, towering trees, whose tops are lost in heavy gray mist, block out all but a death gray light. Tree trunks are unnaturally close to one another, and the woods have the silence of a forgotten grave, yet exude the feeling of an unvoiced scream.
Well, that's creepy.
He's fine.
Okay,
he's good.
Well, that's pretty creepy.
All right. As you continue on the road, you catch the scent of death on the air.
Ooh, I smell that. Anyone smell that? That's a familiar smell to me, man.
Yeah, you're just hungry.
I'm always hungry.
We didn't stop at the Wendy's from the last time we were in. Ye olde Wendy's.
We didn't stick at the ye olde inn of Arby's.
We got the meat.
Arby's Meats. Right. Would you like to try to find the? It's a very particular smell. But you're sure it's a
very particular like a, smell.
It's a body or something. It's not just the place.
Oh, okay. Mm. So this place stinks of death. Mm-hmm. Everyone, I think we should take caution. What should we do now?
We should probably investigate that smell.
Yeah, we should. You're a ranger. How good's your tracking?
I mean, my survival skills are pretty there. Yeah.
Tracking is what you are about. Goddamn ranger.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
So let's why don't you try track down the scent?
Roll for investigation.
Sure. Roll for investigation to try and find the scent.
And mine is 12.
Plus,
what do I have that under?
Is that investigation.
Under? Plus 3, so 15, yeah.
Yeah, he wasn't that far. You really didn't have to roll. You find him. Okay. The foul scent leads you to a human corpse.
Yeah.
Half buried in the underbrush, about 15 feet from the road. The young man appears to be a commoner. His muddy clothes are torn and raked with claw marks.
This man was attacked by werewolves.
Crows have been at the body, which is surrounded by the paw prints. The man has obviously been dead for several days. He holds a crumbled envelope in one hand.
Yoink! Yoink!
I just like to imagine just, like, your character just saying that as he makes it.
That's what he did. That's canon.
That's canon. I said yoink yoink. That's what, like, non-phased I am by this. Okay, I open the letter and.
All right, you tear open the wax seal. And it says, "Hail thee of might and valor! I, the Burgomaster of Barovia, send you honor with despair."
The what?
Burgomaster.
What the heck's a Burgomaster?
You ever see like the old like claymation Santa Claus movie? Like
Rudolph? Where,
no, well, sort of like the when like Santa Claus origin story basically.
Yeah.
Like the guy who's the mayor of the town is the Burgomaster.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay.
I thought it was like a fucking rancher or something.
I, the Burgomaster of Barovia, send you honor with despair. My adopted daughter, the fair Irina Koliana, has been these past nights bitten by a vampire. For over 400 years, this creature has drained the lifeblood of my people. Now, my dear Irina languishes and dies from an unholy wound caused by this vile beast. He has become too powerful to conquer. So I say to you, give us up for dead, and encircle this land with the symbols of good. Let holy men call upon their power, that the devil may be contained within the walls of weeping Barovia. Leave our sorrows to our graves, and save the world from this evil fate of ours. There is much wealth entrapped in this community. Return for your reward after we are all departed for a better life. Kolyan Indirovich, Burgomaster.
More dealing with vampires.
It would seem that way.
Well, you know, I don't know about you, but being a paladin, I think I'm obligated to go help slay this beast.
Right.
I think I'm obligated to slay this beast, so I'm going to go at least attempt to kill this asshole. And I'm going with or without you guys. Is anyone with me?
We'll be going to the middle end. To the bitter end. Where is it?
I don't know.
Where do we go?
I have no idea.
What's your plan, my dude?
Well, they say the first casualty of war is the plan.
What?
He doesn't know. He just got here. He just read a letter. Okay. You don't know where anything.
Remember, he's old.
You don't know where you are.
You're still looking at dirt, by the way.
I mean, you realize you're in Barovia from the context of the letter, but that's about all you know. All
right.
There's a forest, and you're in Barovia.
Possibly, yes.
Well, I say we stick with each other to the bitter end.
I wish I would no other way.
All right. So you're continuing along the road, I presume?
Ace. Ace.
Let's go.
What?
That's ace. It's, okay. It's, I don't know. It's a language, one of the all languages right. I speak for yes.
No, it's not. All right. You keep walking, and you're walking for a good another, let's say hour?
Mm-hmm.
Down this dirt road. It does take a bend at one point.
Okay.
And as you're going along, you can see a town in the distance.
A small town?
Tall shapes loom out of the dense fog that surrounds everything. The muddy ground underfoot gives way to slick, wet cobblestones. The tall shapes become recognizable as village dwellings. The windows of each house stare out from pools of blackness. No sound cuts the silence, except for the mournful sobbing that echoes through the streets from a distance.
Guys, I think we should investigate that crying.
Let's go.
Could
Let's
be
go.
Someone in danger.
Let's go.
Okay, weapons at the ready, men.
All yeah. right, you all take out your weapons, your hammers, your...
I'm drawing out my crossbow.
Take out your crossbow, okay. I should have never given him a crossbow.
Too late, I got a crossbow.
All right, you're looking around for this, the sound of this sobbing.
Wait a minute, we're in a village. People live here, right?
You're in a village. What? You don't see anyone, but...
But people live here.
Probably.
Why are four strangers walking around with weapons? Isn't that a little dangerous?
It is some shady shit,
That's
yeah.
some shady shit, guys.
Well, we're going to investigate someone crying. It could be a witch for all we know.
What if it's just the mourning mother? And wait, and then all of a sudden, four strangers come with weapons at the door.
Then
surprise! It's weapon time!
Okay, then we'll send you in!
Okay, I'll go in.
We'll send you in, because you're freaking like magic, and magic doesn't require weapons. This isn't Harry Potter where you need a freaking wand.
Let's just go investigate, boys.
You need a wand for something.
Okay.
All right, so you're looking for the sound of this crying. Mm-hmm. All right. The moaning sob floats through the still gray streets, coloring your thoughts with sadness. The sound flows from a dark two-story townhouse. What do you want to do?
Investigate.
All right.
Wait, what's around the townhouse? Like, what is surrounding it?
Look. There's a house next door. There's another house next door. It's just houses. There's not a lot going on. It's a two-story townhouse. It looks very drab. Everything is very drab,
right
though.
Now we're standing in front of a two-story house.
You're standing in front of a two-story house.
Okay. I'm going to knock on the door.
All right, you knock and... You just, there's not really any response. You continue to hear the sobbing.
Okay, I'm going to slowly open up the door.
All right,
before I open it up, I'm going to check to see if the door is unlocked.
It is unlocked.
Okay, then I'm going to open up the door, and then I'm going to have my shield out, so just in case, like, if anyone jumps at me, so I can just block the door with my shield.
Okay. No, nothing happens when you open the door, and you can hear the wailing a lot more clearly now.
You're gonna need a frog on me. You're gonna be my backup, okay?
Yeah. Let the two tanks investigate the house.
I'll be in the back.
Yeah. No one.
I'm gonna disguise myself as a barrel.
The mage and I are gonna kick it out back. Do the whole smoking. All right.
The crying pipe. Sounds like it's coming from upstairs.
Okay. So here's what I'm. I got a plan. Okay. You and I are going to go in. As we're going to investigate upstairs. You're gonna stay downstairs, just in case they run downstairs. If they run downstairs, you're gonna try to stop them. Don't hurt them if they don't attack you. Just try to stop them if you can. You're gonna be outside in case they jump out the window or something.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. So
you're going upstairs.
Everyone got the plan?
Yeah. Okay. Got my arrow out.
Are you listening?
Yeah. Both of us run upstairs. Okay. They stay downstairs just in case the guy jumps out. Checking. Noah's outside. Just in case someone jumps out the window.
Mm-hmm. Alright, just checking. This isn't conspicuous at all. Alright, so you two, you head upstairs. And inside, you step into a bedroom, a very grably decorated bedroom, and you see a woman with her back to you. And she appears to be clutching something in her hand.
Noah's making a two-story house, by the way.
She's just like on her knees sobbing.
Sad.
I ask her what's wrong.
And she like turns around and she's like, who are you?
Do not fear, I mean, do not be afraid. I am merely a holy paladin of Shantae. All right.
She looks like this, by the way. This woman.
Looks like that.
I can't see.
I know I'm okay. Trying to hide the rest of the page from you.
Guys, so.
She's like, it's like, my daughter, Gertruda. She was taken.
Taken by who?
By the devil.
Dun, dun, dun.
And as she turns around, you see she's got this very, this kind of flimsy, crappy doll in her hands.
By the devil, old lady, the mom, who by the, what do you mean by the devil?
Devil Strahd. He looms over us. I tried to protect her for so many years, I tried. But she's gone.
Who is Strahd?
He is the Dark Lord who rules this land. And she's crying while she says this.
Guys,
she is extremely distraught.
So, Krog, I think we have figured out who the vampire is.
Let's tell the others.
Yes. You go do that. I'm gonna see if I can't comfort this woman.
So I go downstairs and I tell them everything.
Okay, you go down and you tell them like there's a lady up there. And she tells you no doubt he took her. She's in his castle right now. Probably. God knows what he's doing. My poor Gertruda.
Okay. I asked her. I asked her. It's like, do you know where is this Strahd fellow?
Ravenloft. And she says it like quietly. Like she looks around. Like she's afraid to say the name.
Okay. So and where is Ravenloft? By the way, can you just point us in the general direction?
When you go outside, you can see it on the mountain.
I see. I know. Okay. Thank you, Miss
Mary.
No, Miss Mary, I am. I know this might be hard for you, but is it possible that I take your that doll from you?
All I have left of my little girl.
If it has your little girl's scent, then my little friend here might be able to track her.
No.
We have a ranger with us. He might be able to track her.
I don't remember you saying you could use your mouse for tracking.
It's a mouse. Mice have very nice, strong sense of smell. Trust me.
Not a bloodhound. I remember you telling you that it's a familiar that can carry out your orders.
Well, you just destroyed the house. And now we're all dead.
Yeah. Oh, I mean.
Game's over.
Yeah, Tiamat crushes the house.
This is
moving down and breathing fire.
This is why you don't use the mouse.
If we give it to your little girl, maybe we can convince her to come with us because she doesn't trust us.
Give me a perception check, or a persuasion roll.
Seven. Plus five, that's 12.
No. It's all I have left of her, please.
Okay.
Leave me this one piece of my... of my daughter, but I still had her.
Okay, then, Shantae, bless you, and I kind of just leave.
Okay. She goes back to crying, just sobbing. And you walk outside the house, and you can see to the east, I believe, to the northeast, you can see a castle spire looming over this small village.
I tell my friends, I tell my allies, so this woman told me about this, that castle on over yonder. This is known as, apparently it's known as Ravenloft. And that's where this vampire lord named Strahd is being, is a, resides. I assume he's going down to this town and perhaps other towns like this area and kidnapping people to either feast or add to his army of, I don't know, undead or children slaves or whatever.
Ents.
Ents work for elves, okay?
Hey!
Do they?
Yes, they do.
What was I saying about taking things personally?
I can take ents, but elves, that's my people.
You didn't even say that's anything bad. He said ents work for elves, which isn't even completely true.
Well, to my knowledge, I know that elf. To my knowledge,
crazy old man. I'm crazy old man, I say.
PTSD. Oh yes, that's the demon. Anyways, so what now, my friends? We know where we should go. We know who we have to kill, and we know who we have to save.
Let's do it.
All right.
What? Village, what, are there any shops in the village?
You can look around, and you're pretty familiar with,
Can you say your name?
Icelius.
Icelius, can you pass me the
cities.
Please?
So, I think after a little bit of searching around, you do end up finding a small shop, which is, goddamn, where I'm trying to find my shit. Yes, you find a shop with, the sparse light from this building spills out from behind drawn heavy curtains. And a sign over the door, creaking on its hinges, reads, Bildrath's Mercantile.
Okay.
What's mercantile?
Just merchant, basically.
Oh. It's Squidward.
All right, let's enter.
So,
you want to go in there?
Yeah, let's enter.
Okay, cool.
We got plenty of gold.
That's it. All right, you step inside, and it's a small shop. It's lined with a lot of very basic adventuring gear. You can see like rope and crowbar and lamps and whatnot.
Do they have stakes?
Huh?
Like wooden stakes?
No, it doesn't look like it.
Oh. I asked. I called
the
call
and there's
asked,
a there's
morning.
A male human standing behind the counter. He's balding. He's just kind of a very pale fellow, with kind of a just a not nice person look about vibe about him in his face.
Okay, I'm gonna go up to the man and just kind of like, hello there, good sir. What is this? What is your name?
I'm Bildrath. Can't you read?
Well, you know,
this is my shop.
Wanted to make sure.
Yeah.
I wanted to make sure Bildrath isn't dead and you haven't just stolen his business.
But you coming in, that's a great first impression. Accusing people of thievery.
Also accusing people of being dead.
That too!
Oh yes, I'm a human person.
What do you want?
Supplies.
Alright, what kind of supplies? We got lots of stuff.
What do you got, old man?
Alright, give me the player's handbook. And you can see just around his shop, like I told you, he's got a lot of
I'll probably buy myself another health potion.
Normal gear. He doesn't appear to have any health potion.
God damn it!
You don't
cheap
see any.
Bastard.
You can ask.
Do you have health potions?
No.
Do you have any? Holy icons of Dacism?
Do you have any holy icons of Dacism?
The fuck is Dacism?
It's a new religion. Would you like to join?
God no.
I got pamphlets.
Yeah, get out of here. Hurry up, get your shit and get out.
Get your shit and get out.
Do you have any wooden stakes?
No, you crazy?
Wait, does he have wooden stakes?
No, you crazy? I don't got any wooden stakes. You can see around.
What about garlic?
He has.
Do you have regular stakes?
Layers.
No, he doesn't have regular stakes. There's a lot of normal stuff, like you can see quiver pouches. Oh, he doesn't have potion healing. lanterns, jugs, hourglass,
what kind of lantern, what
hunting traps.
What kind of lanterns? Are they like oil lanterns?
I would assume they're oil lanterns. Okay. It doesn't specifically tell me. Like bullseye lanterns, hooded lanterns, locks.
Lamp oils, ropes,
arrows,
bombs. You want it? It's yours, my
abacuses,
friend.
As long as you have enough
backpacks.
Movies.
Do they have bolts?
Crossbow bolts?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got some crossbow bolts.
How many?
How many do you want to buy?
I want to buy two. So I can just round out to 20.
You want to buy two?
Yeah.
All right, he's like, you tell him you want to buy.
I want to buy two crossbow bolts, my good man, to start off, at least.
All right, that'll be 20 gold.
20 gold for two bolts?
No one else around here to buy them.
Fair point. And what if I wanted other items? Will you increase the price then?
The prices are what the prices are.
Okay, then what about a lantern as well?
Lantern is, which one you want?
How?
We got the hooded lantern and we got the bullseye lantern.
What's the difference?
The hooded lantern is,
That's hooded.
50 gold. Bullseye is 100 gold.
You did not tell me what's the difference between the two.
Hooded lantern is basically like, I think you can cover it up.
Oh,
I'm honestly not sure what the fuck a bullseye lantern is.
Can we do a charisma check for haggling?
Yeah, someone haggle actually.
Who has the most charisma?
You can say something and attempt to haggle.
I have 16 charisma.
You guys
have I have 11 charisma. With
I've got.
That was your dump skill.
No,
19 charisma.
No, go for
so
it.
So don't expect me to sweet talk the guy.
I'm gonna see if I can haggle for him a bit, okay?
It's like, hey there, sexy.
I wanna try to haggle.
Wait, what's your charisma?
Can my character be bisexual? Is that canon?
Oh,
you can make him bisexual, I don't care.
Oh, he's bisexual. That's my canon. Okay. Hey.
You wanna
haggle? Nice shoppy guy right here.
You actually say that?
Yeah, I'm like, hey, nice shoppy guy right here.
He just kinda gives you a dirty look like what the fuck is up with you, and then he notices your ears, your pointy ears.
This doing anything for you, buddy?
You actually say that?
Yes, that's canon.
That's canon. I'm just like, got a thing for
yes,
else?
Yes, that makes him.
He doesn't know what to say. He's just like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
I'm sure a lot of things.
Okay, I'm gonna.
You got something wrong with your eyebrows?
You gonna haggle?
I'm gonna haggle, sir. We are heading up to that castle in the northeast to.
Ravenloft,
yes, what do you know about it?
I know you probably have a death wish.
We're there to get one of your customer. Her daughter's missing, and we're gonna get her back.
And
what can we get a discount that'll help us?
I'm not losing money just for you fools. I trade good money with them Vistani types to get these goods.
We'll give you a share.
If you wanna go off and waste your lives trying to kill Strahd, that's your business. You go off and be stupid like that is Mark fella.
Who's this Mark?
I guess he's the Burgomaster now. Don't know where to find him exactly. But I know he's always been training to fight Strahd. Damn fool if you ask me. Young idiot.
I think we should talk to this,
Ismark.
Where's Ismark? He points in the right direction.
I don't know where he is.
He just said that. He doesn't know where he is.
What do I look like? A damn tourist booth?
What if I get so you don't know where he is, right?
I don't know. Check the bar.
Whose bar?
The bar.
Okay. Because you said check with bar.
I said check with the bar. Don't tell me what I said.
Okay, fine. Okay,
Do you still want that lamp?
You know what, I have 200 gold, I'll pay for it for my
You
own.
Know for a fact that he is swindling you with the price of the lamp.
Okay, you know what, if you can't haggle.
And I think one of you might have, do you have a fucking light cantrip or something?
No, I don't.
Really, you don't have dancing lights or?
I don't, I did not get a light one.
I'm just gonna try to save you some time and see if like prestidigitation can do that. Cause like, goddamn, you're wasting a lot of fucking.
Can you just at least just see if you can hack and haggle?
I mean,
if you can, just roll.
I mean, you can light candles, I think. Do you guys have candles?
You don't have
candles. You got torches and shit.
When did we get torches?
You have them in your bag.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you guys got torches.
Okay, never mind. Let's just head over to the bar then, guys.
We don't need your shit.
Nah, get out. I don't like you. Get out of my store. Periwimple.
And have a good day, sir.
This buff guy fucking comes out like, yeah, uncle. He's a fucking dude. He's as big as Krog. Like, what? Get him out of here.
It's another one of you.
No, he's not a half-orc.
Thank you for your service, good sir.
Shantaya bless you. Okay, so I leave. So we leave, and I'm heading to the bar, guys. Anyone want to join?
Alcoholic.
I'll join you.
All right. You.
I think you should stay outside.
You look around and just, actually, like, right across the street, you do see what looks like a tavern. A single shaft of light thrusts illumination into the main square, its brightness looking like a solid pillar in the heavy fog. Above the gaping doorway, a sign hangs, precariously askew, proclaiming this to be the Blood on the Vine Tavern.
Blood on the Vine.
Yes.
Sounds classic.
As you step up closer, you see it originally read Blood of the Vine, but an N has been scratched over the F. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm heading in. Anyone else?
No. In the tavern?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Let's do it, homies.
Alright, the four of you step in, and you see a homie looking, although gloomy, looking little tavern here. There are some people inside. There is a bartender, who's a pudgy little man, and very gray pallor. He's kind of like cleaning glasses. Like, there are three very lovely looking women, all in very colorful outfits, sitting together. They look like they could be sisters. And in the back, there's one guy who's very dour looking, who's just kind of by himself. Yeah, and there is a hearth, a fire hearth, burning, providing some scant warmth.
Okay. We're gonna talk to Soa. I think we should plan this out. There's three people here. I think we should talk to them. Who do you think we should talk to? And then split up so we can come.
All right, you're all just that are huddled around the doorway at the moment.
Okay, then how about we all come? Okay, so
the barkeeper doesn't even notice you. He's just like,
okay, well,
I'll talk to the barkeeper.
Yeah.
Come with me. I know you want a drink.
Okay, I'll talk to the ladies then.
The tank, right. Stay behind, and the
tank. What are you doing?
Who wants to go first?
Those two could go first.
Alright, cool. You step up to the bar, and this barkeep kind of just gives you a look and like,
what have you got?
Wine.
Just wine?
Just wine.
How much?
Copper. One copper for a glass. One silver for a pitcher.
I have, where's my currency? I have
currency right here.
Oh.
You have like 145.
I have 20 silver pieces, I have no copper pieces, and 180 gold.
Two wines, please, sir. Two coppers on
it. Alright. He pours you, erase two copper from your money. He pours you two glasses of wine from some of the glasses that he has, and he pushes them towards you, and he goes back to clean the glass. Doesn't take any notice of you.
So what's the haps? What's 411, sir? What's the do that goes on?
The fuck's going on around here?
As you say that, the three women in colorfully dressed kind of peer over, and so does the guy in the corner. But the barkeep, he's just sort of like, goes back to cleaning the glass.
Vampires? People getting kidnapped? Seems like that doesn't seem like everyone's having a good time here.
And as you say that, the guy who's sitting in the corner walks up to you, like, and he says, yes, we do seem to be having our fair share of problems around here as of late.
Care to elaborate?
You seem to know some of it. Well, what do you know about the vampires and disappearances?
That, the lady lost her daughter, and the vampire, somebody by the name of Strahd or something?
Somebody named Eastmark?
Or Eastmark?
Eastmark?
Yeah.
Walmart?
Walmart?
I am Eastmark.
Oh! Well, hello. My name's Ashton, this is, Axelius.
So, good to meet you. Bartender, another one for my friends here. Another glass. And the bartender kind of pours you another glass. Sass up for you. Yes, we've been having... For hundreds of years, we have dealt with the Devil's Strahd, but... And he has always loomed over us. We are powerless against him. He took Gertruda, of course, recently, and Mary has been, unfortunately, driven mad. But that is not the most disturbing.
She was driven mad, she rather sane.
She is constantly crying, wailing for her lost daughter.
Never mind, I retract my statement.
Yeah, that we pretty much got that.
But you mentioned someone missing problems with a daughter. I do not have a daughter. I know, but however, my sister, Irina, the devil has been coming for her as of late.
Where's she at?
She is in our house, the burgomaster's mansion.
I'm sorry, I was just asking your proper question. I was about to be like, is she hot?
That's canon.
Is she hot?
He kind of looks you over, like, and he can kind of see that you guys are, especially you with your freaking like haunted eyes, like he can see you've seen some shit. Like, I've actually been hoping for someone to help me get her to a safer place, like Valaki, where it's more fortified. Strahd has charmed her, allowed her to welcome him into the house. He is drunk from her. I want to get her to where it's safe. Perhaps you men look like you could handle yourselves. Could you perhaps help me in this endeavor?
Depends. Are you coming with us?
Of course. I need to keep my sister safe.
NBC!
What's our reward?
I could pay you well. Now that I am the burgomaster, I suppose I could give you something out of the treasury. Pay you handsomely?
How much is handsomely?
I will figure it out when the job is done.
I see, ladies, don't be ruining this job for us.
I'll pay you handsomely. This is a picture of my face. See how handsome it is?
He is actually kind of a handsome dude. He,
Oh, is he now?
Maybe, I guess. Looking at it again. He looks like that.
He's
okay. He's about a five.
He's about a five on the Richter scale.
Six.
He probably like
him. Is that a six?
No, he probably looks a lot better if he wasn't so stressed out.
He is, yeah. He's also very pale, obviously. Everyone here is pale.
Give him a little tan.
No, he's not tan.
No, give him a little tan.
He doesn't have the chance to get a tan.
I know, but if he did, he'd probably look a lot better.
Alright, I'm sorry, what are you doing?
You were talking to the three.
You were talking about money. Haggle. Yeah, you're haggling again.
I just want to haggle once. Is that too much to ask?
I haggled once during the last thing we did, and that didn't even work. God damn, my Christmas sucks.
He kicked you out.
No, he still sold me the potion. He just didn't sell me at a half price like I wanted to.
Okay, so I'm talking to the three ladies.
Okay, you walk up to these three women, and they were kind of chatting, but they shut up as soon as you get close. You approach them.
A very armored, muscular.
Yes, this huge paladin in white and gold armor. And I'm like, can we help you?
I asked him, he's like, I'm looking for a man named, what's his name? Ismark?
Yes, Ismark.
I'm looking for a man named Ismark.
That's him over there. Your friend is talking to him.
Okay.
But he's not worth talking to. Ismark the Lesser. Ha!
Why is he named Ismark the Lesser? People generally don't get entitled for that reason.
He's always just lived in his father's shadow. He can't hope to be a good leader.
Let's see. Why don't you tell me about the things going on around here? What's been going on?
And another one says, like, well, whatever do you mean?
Well, I heard this man, Strahd, has kidnapped a little girl named Gertruda.
And their eyes kind of furrow as soon as you mention Strahd.
So, have there been anyone else that has been captured? Has there been a pattern as of late?
We don't know anything about kidnappings, and another one says, like, we just run the bar.
Can I
own it, really.
Can I make a
Arik
perception
takes
test?
Care of the bar. Huh?
Can I make a perception test?
Make a perception check for
me. It's like 20.
It's right there.
Oh, thank you. Perception. Okay, that cocked.
You cocked it up?
Yeah.
You cocking things up already, Andy?
I got a 9. 9 plus 2.
That looked like a 6, but
really?
Okay.
Okay.
Either way, you get the sense that they're not really... they're not really telling you everything, but they don't necessarily, like, you have no clue what. You just get the sense that they don't really... You ask, they don't really want to talk to you that much.
I see.
Because you're old, man.
Yeah.
He's lost, old man.
Okay, can I offer them food to see that? Though they don't really even know. I know that they're probably hiding some stuff from me, but not much.
You don't know. You can't tell. You just know they don't want to talk to you, mostly.
Okay, can I try? I'm going to see if I can't bribe them a bit. I'm going to offer you 20 gold to tell me whatever information. I'm going to offer you 20 gold for, actually, no, 15 gold. I'm going to offer each of them. I'm going to offer them each 5 gold for any information they could give me.
So you offer them the gold, and they're like, we own a tavern, we don't need your petty gold.
This year going to be
and we have nothing to tell you.
You sure? It's free gold.
We are sure.
Sure. Fine, then, good day to you. God may have blessed. And I leave.
And they just go back to their conversation quietly.
I leave back to them, join these two.
Krog, you want to do anything?
Standing in the doorway like a creep.
Yeah, just this huge
shot,
dude.
Shot.
Free drink for everyone.
Everybody.
I'm totally up to ground.
We're all having a serious conversation, and then Krog is just fucking hammering down.
He's doing the music himself too. He pulls out his fucking clarinet. He's dancing on tables.
Two other human maidens just like behind him while he's like rolling dice on a table.
I drink from my clarinet.
You don't have to do anything. You've been quiet this whole time.
Yeah, so you're just eating sunflower seeds.
Yeah. So I'll just stay in that.
You're just gonna stand awkwardly in the doorway?
Keep an eye. If anything.
Okay, you're just sort of keeping an eye out.
You don't want to roll a quick perception check to make sure nothing fishy is happening?
Sure. Do it.
Roll the roll.
You don't have to roll, you can just kind of see, like, the bartender is not doing anything. There's really nothing outside, just foggy, but you can't see much.
Yeah, we have these.
The three women, colorfully dressed women, are just kind of staring at you, but they're not paying any particular attention to you. And, Aecilius and Ashton are talking to the blonde man at the bar.
Okay, so I'm heading back to Aecilius and Ashton. Like, can I what's some you saw him look like the guy?
Is Mark? Yeah, trouble with names, man.
Sorry, I have to know you for this.
Well, he looks like that. He's just kind of a 6. he's got a strong jaw, he's got blonde hair, he's very pale.
I go up to the man and
he's dressed in very nice beauty. Like,
I go up to the man and ask him, he's like, are you Ismark?
Yes, I am Ismark.
I heard those three women over there call you the Lesser.
Yes, people have taken to calling me that.
Is there any particular reason why?
My father was the burgomaster of the village of Barovia. I suppose some people don't think that I am going to make a good burgomaster. So they call me Ismark the Lesser.
Who could be a good burgomaster in these tough times?
Honestly, I don't know if anyone could do a good job.
That's the point!
But I hope to just serve my people and do the best of my ability.
Well, getting rid of that vampire might help out.
speak of Strahd. I would hope that one day he could be killed, yes.
Have you been taking anyone else as of late? Besides that of all, Mary's daughter.
Gertrude, no, I do not know. Not that I have heard. But I fear that he will come to take my sister soon. He covets her. He visits the house. His minions are all around, constantly attacking the house at night.
Minions?
Yes. Wolves and zombies.
Ooh, wolves and zombies. Unholy abominations.
Yes.
Wolves, zombies, vampires. This has been turned into a weird day.
Hey, maybe one of them could be a werewolf.
The undead serve Strahd, as do the wolves of this land. They only work at his command. They cannot be scared away or charmed or anything. They kill at his behest.
Well, you said you needed to get your sister out of here. Boys, I think we've been here long enough.
We have a traveling circus. Perhaps she could join our...
Circus?
Yes, a traveling circus. Perhaps she could join us under the guise of one of our entertainers.
It might be worth a shot, but I don't think Strahd would forget her so easily from this place.
Well,
I wish to get, her to Velaki. Oh. It's heavily fortified. She would be safer there.
Guys, how much makeup we got on hand?
I can disguise her.
We get uglier up. We got uglier up.
I've got
it. Still have the wolf.
Oh, you know what? I have a disguise kit.
Yes, you do.
I can ugly her up.
Okay. So, shall we head over to the Burgermeister's mansion, or is it a house or a mansion?
It is a mansion.
Okay, mansion.
All right. So you got Ismark leads you to the Burgermeister's mansion.
Burgermeister.
E7. Where the hell is it? Oh, it's E7. Okay. So he walks you and he takes you basically to the edge of town, and you see this a weirdly looking mansion squatting behind a rusting iron fence. The iron gates are twisted and torn. The right gate lies cast aside while the left swings lazily in the wind. The stuttering squeal and clang of the gate repeats with mindless precision. Weeds choke the grounds and press with menace upon the house itself. Yet against the walls, the growth has been tramped down to create a path all about the domain. Heavy claw markings have stripped the once beautiful finish of the walls. Great black marks tell of the fires that have assailed the mansion. Not a pane nor a shard of glass stands in any window. All the windows are barred with planks, each one marked with the stains of evil omen.
Homely.
Yes, we have been dealing with the attacks for some time now.
And these gates are all that keeps the monsters out?
Nothing can keep the monsters out but us.
So you fight them?
We try. My father, the attacks have been increasing as of late, and my father is... His heart could not stand it. His body lies within.
By increasing, you mean in size or frequency?
Both. And he walks up to the door and he unlocks it. And as you guys step inside, you see several things aside from this mansion. Just this general, like the stairs and the just drabness and furniture and whatnot. You see a very beautiful woman with auburn hair and a...
Auburn?
Yes, auburn.
Okay.
So brown. She looks like that. She's wearing some armor. And she's got a scarf around her neck. And then... Yes.
A solid 8.
Yeah, she's... No, she's a 9. She's easily a 9.
If you weren't wearing armor, she'd be 10.
And then, off to the side, you do see... A what looks to be handmade, like kind of hastily put together coffin with a old man lying in it.
Is the old man rotted or is he just...
No, he's fine. The interior of the mansion is well furnished, yet the fixtures show signs of great wear. Noticeable oddities are the boarded up windows and the presence of holy symbols in the room. All about. The burgomaster is in the side drawing room, and it's a simple wooden coffin. And it's surrounded by wilting flowers and a faint odor of decay.
So the body's been decaying for a bit?
And as you step inside, the woman, she goes, Ismar, who are these people? It's like, these are some strangers. Hopefully they can help us, Irina. This is my sister, Irina. And she, gestures to her.
I'm just gonna give her a small wave while I go to the
I give her a little.
She hits it.
I love you.
She kind of she doesn't know how to. You're a very odd looking group. It's kind of clear that from the looks you've been getting from people, it's clear they've never seen anyone like you guys.
Just
this paladin in golden white armor and this ranger, this guy in the full.
This devil and.
You're the most normal looking. But you're a half elf.
Yeah.
And you haven't seen anyone
like
that.
You got a red skinned devil practically.
Yeah, you've got Satan in a magician's costume. And then you've got super tall, super gray, super buff Conan the Barbarian over here in a costume or shirt. Are you in your costume or are you shirtless?
No, I didn't put it on.
Sure. You're shirtless?
Oh okay. God. Showing off that 15 pack already or what?
You're freaking super big.
Just rippling muscles. He's got a 20 on his strength, people. How's the camera doing? Just asking. Is it telling you low battery?
No.
We good?
We're good.
If it's plugged into the house, it should be fine.
Oh.
Should I tell them? I didn't even think it was turned on.
God damn it. John, are you fucking kidding me?
Yeah, I'm bored.
That was literally your one job. You had one job, John.
Fine. Let me zoom in.
All right, cool. We're using Meg's footage.
I can just walk out and be done with this.
You had one job.
That's how bored I am. You gotta keep me busy or else I'm just gonna...
You could have been watching this. We're doing shit, man.
Yeah.
God damn it. All right. Where the fuck were we?
We're a rambunctious group.
Yeah.
Okay, yes.
I'm gonna go. Oh, everyone's...
Okay, you two are just standing there awkwardly.
Mm-hmm. I don't actually think he has what skills with health. Just a nice candlestick.
Why did you play a wizard instead of a rogue?
I'm part rogue. I grew up thinking I'm not.
You
gonna
grew up as an urchin. You're not a rogue.
I'm not gonna steal anything. I'm just thinking about
it. Something.
Okay.
That's fine.
That's your character.
So the windows are boarded up with holy symbols.
They are boarded up and there are holy symbols.
Yeah, I'm gonna go check these holy symbols.
Yeah.
I'm a paladin, so I'm gonna see what these holy symbols are. And they could be of use for if we ever get attacked.
Yeah, you look at the holy symbols and it appears to be a sunburst. And you can make a religion check for me if you want to see and find out what they are.
Okay.
If you recognize it at all.
Okay, I'm just going to check my religion. 17, 19.
Okay, it's not the same as the ones you've seen, but it looks to be kind of a variation on the symbol of Lathander. The god of the sun and birth and renewal. Rebirth and renewal.
Okay, that's the one we had in the temple.
Yeah, the temple in Branchwood was a temple of the Thander.
Okay. I got curious, what symbols are these? Are these like Thander?
That is the symbol of the Morning Lord, yes.
They do not look like the ones that I've seen in my time as a paladin.
Well, I don't know what they would normally look like. But that is the symbol of the Morning Lord here.
Yeah.
Quickly.
I don't want to ask anything else.
Irina goes like, Brother, I will not leave until Father is buried. It's like, we have to get you to safety though. Like, I will not let him lie dead on the mansion floor while we flee.
to bury him.
And he kind of just, he turns to you, would you be so kind as to help us take my father to the church?
Yeah. What church is this? What church is this?
It is a church of the Morning Glory.
I see.
I'll carry it.
Okay.
It is just on the other side. Okay, yeah, you're gonna carry it?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, Krong just kind of goes over and, like, Ismark, like, he goes to kind of help you carry the coffin, but then you just kind of lift it up on, like, one, onto your shoulder all by yourself.
Terminator 3?
Yeah, so Krong's got the whole coffin.
This was a friggin' like sci-fi movie. He probably holds the coffin and holding an LMG in the other hand.
That's what I'm saying. It's Terminator 3.
He can't. I will say he can still use his battle axe one-handed if he really needs to.
Oh, you're super cute. I love you so much right now. Oh man.
All right. How long have we been recording? Does it tell?
It's restarted like about.
We're on 2 o'clock.
Hour 30 minutes.
Huh?
Hour 30
okay.
Minutes.
Okay, we got it. We'll do it a little bit more.
Yeah, I just got that stupid camera working.
All right, cool. So you head across, he takes you all the way across town, pretty much. Atop a slight rise, against the root of the pillar stone that supports Castle Ravenloft, stands a gray, sagging edifice of stone and wood.
Raver.
This church has obviously weathered the assaults of evil for centuries on end, and is worn and weary. A bell tower rises toward the back, and a flickering light shines through the holes in the shingled roof. The rafters strain feebly against their load. And as you get closer, you can see the heavy wooden doors of the church are covered with claw marks and scarred by fire.
I asked Ismark, how come this church looks so decrepit?
Strahd does not like the Morning Lord, our other holy symbols. Obviously, he's a vampire. They are one of the things that can be a weakness to him. That and the Morning Lord gives people hope. Strahd does not like the people of Barovia to have hope.
What about this, the claw mark?
That would be the wolves and others of Strahdians.
It's them ghouls.
The ghouls.
The feral ghouls.
Alright, you're going in the church?
Okay. Anyone?
Who's going in? You're still hefting the coffin and go inside.
I was just like distracted by the dominoes for whatever reason.
I roll a 2. That's in check.
All right, as you guys open the doors, and the doors open to reveal a 10-foot wide, 20-foot long hall, leading to a brightly lit chapel. The hall is unlit and reeks of mildew.
Ew, mildew.
4 doors, 2 on each side of the hall, lead to adjacent chambers. You can see that the chapel is strewn with debris, and you hear a soft voice from within reciting a prayer. Suddenly, the prayer is blotted out by an inhuman scream that rises up from beneath the floor.
Oh, crap.
Well.
Ah! Thank you.
Oh, crap. Okay, so what do we say, man? To arms?
I guess.
To arms! I draw my crossbow and kind of.
As you yell that, the priest turns around and says, like, ah! You kind of break him out of his prayer. Who are you? Ismark, who are these people? It's like, they are adventurers. They are going to help us. We wish to bury our father. Oh yes, yes.
Before we continue, can I ask Ismark? I want to ask you this, Mark. How come you couldn't bury your father before?
Strahd's minions are constantly attacking us. It is not safe for Irina to leave the house.
Left the house
I am not confident. Well, we have. I was not confident in my ability to protect her all by myself. The villagers, none of them are brave enough to help her. They stay away from her. They believe she is cursed.
I see. Okay. That's what I want. That's all I wanted to know. I'm hearing his voice from now on.
Yes. Okay. That's fine. Yeah.
Ivanovich,
will you help us bury our father? Like, yes, of course, I can I will prepare the burial rites. Golian was a good burgomaster. He deserves to be put at rest. And as he says that, you guys hear from beneath the floorboards like, Father! Father, I'm starving!
What the hell is that?
Sounds like someone's got the rat.
And
the
priest, he looks like that.
Oh, he's a negative two.
Yeah. He's
negative.
He's an old man. He goes like, he looks very disturbed by that. And he does a quick prayer again, like. Did you actually ask what the hell was that?
Yes, I asked that.
You said that?
Yeah, I said, what the hell is that?
That was my son, Toru. A year ago, a wizard showed up in Barovia.
we was looking at Noah.
everyone looked at Aeselius.
That's canon, like, when we say wizard, we all looked at Noah, and, or Aeselius, and he's like...
He inspired many of the villagers to revolt against the tyranny of Strahd. My son, my poor son, he went with them. Many of them ran. The wizard was killed. And Strahd sent Toru back to me.
This wizard, was he blind in one eye?
I do not know, I did not see him.
Father! I'm hungry!
What's wrong with him? It's hungry, goddammit!
Strahd sent him back to me as a vampire.
Dun dun dun.
Father! I'm starving!
Is there a way to reverse the curse?
I do not know.
Father!
Oh my god. How come you haven't put him out of his misery?
I pray to the Morning Lord for a way to save my son, but I don't know how to do it. The townsfolk, they stay away from the church now. They believe this place is cursed. I pray that one day this can be fixed, but I do not know. I pray for guidance as well.
May I see your son?
Yes, do you believe you can help?
I do not know. I do not know. My faith is... I believe in Shantae, and perhaps she might be able to help your son if the Morning Lord is unable to.
Isn't Shantae the god of crops?
Yeah.
Shantae is a goddess of agriculture.
Help you.
Agriculture, give birth to life.
She is romantically involved with Lathander, you do know that. God's getting it on!
this is why I'm not religious.
Oh, yeah, it says you, Mr. Dacism.
Yeah, Mr. Dacism over here.
Well, yeah, okay. That says there is no greater religion than Dacism.
Give me those chips,
you're
I'm dying
of your
here.
Own religion.
What do you got over there, Zach?
Please.
Hey, we could use drinks.
Okay, where the hell is the fucking bullshit on this? Alright, so he leads you into a... Where the fuck does this come from, actually? Hold on, I'm trying to see exactly where the goddamn trapdoor is.
Trapdoor where his son's being kept?
Yeah, because you heard the sound of him screaming from under the floor.
Under the floorboards!
There it is! Right under there! Right under the floorboards!
Okay, yes, he leads you into the first room on the right, and he opens up a trapdoor. We got cut off, we had some technical difficulties.
We're back though, baby!
Yeah.
Hey.
We saved the footage, thankfully. Everything's good. Everything's good in Barovia.
Thank the tech
crew. Nothing but good things are happening.
No, it's not.
Thank the tech crew.
Oh, that's some fan praise.
Alright, so. Where were we? We were in the trap. Okay.
Time and neglect have punched holes in the ceiling of this moldy room, which contains a few broken roof shingles amid puddles of water. In one corner, set into the floor, is a heavy wooden trapdoor, held shut with a chain and padlock. A young man's screams of anguish can be heard through the door.
Ah! Father, help me!
You can say your question you had before.
Because
he said something. We only lost like 5 seconds.
So I told him, I asked him, how long have he been this way?
For about a year.
And you have not fed him?
I did not feed him. He is not calling to me when he asks his father to feed him.
Strahd?
Yes.
How has he survived a year with him?
Because he is a vampire.
Won't they starve him?
Yeah.
I'm just out of character. But...
he's undead.
Shouldn't he be, like, insane?
Huh?
Shouldn't he be insane?
He is insane.
I'm sorry, do you need to ask? You want to make an insight check as to whether Aurelius can fucking piece together whether the crazy vampire spawn in the basement has lost his marbles? Is that necessary?
I really don't want to waste it, no.
Alright, I'm just checking. Yes, we are recording. No, it's not on low battery. Alright. So he opens up this trapdoor, and you walk in, I assume, yes?
Yes.
There is a staircase, and you can see this young man, this tormented looking young man, who looks like that.
Probably like a two.
Nah, he's a one.
He's very sad.
Even paler than everyone else, if that's even possible. His eyes are very... his hair is very distressed. His face is just completely, like, in anguish. He has fangs you can see jutting out. He's like, Father! Help me!
Is he, like, locked in a cage?
He's not locked in a cage. He's just down.
Is he restrained by anything?
He is not restrained in any way.
He's just trapped there.
Yes. And Donovich.
Low battery.
Huh?
Low battery.
Son of a bitch!
Meg's either overheated or is dead completely. So Meg is sad.
Meg's footage is saved.
Meg's footage was very nice.
Now let's give a moment of silence for Meg's camera.
Moment of silence.
Okay, moment over.
Okay, so yeah, you're in the basement with a vampire spawn. What is everyone else doing, by the way? He walked down with him, I'm not sure what the rest of
you are. Aren't we all walking down with him, dude?
Did you all do that?
I just assume we're all together.
No, I'm staying upstairs.
Krog is upstairs with a coffin.
You know what's funny?
He's still got the coffin
hoisted over. Krog is the one most useful against a fucking vampire. He's probably the most useful.
Yeah, how is he the most useful?
You've had experience.
You're a super mutant.
Guys, let's not bring race into it.
Oh yes, let's not bring race into it, Mr. Your Kind.
I'm trying to amend my wrongdoings.
He's a recovering drug addict, okay?
He's a recovering racist.
I'm a recovering racist.
Alright, is there anything you want to do? What?
I'm gonna ask the priest, he's not restrained by it.
Is he dangerous?
Okay,
oh,
one thing at a time, Donovich says,
he's a vampire,
he was.
So.
And at that point, Doru runs towards you. Roll for initiative. And let's set up a little basement here.
I got it. 20. Oh, right in front of my face.
Set up a nice little basement here. They're gonna fall down if we put them like that.
Wait, should we
This will be the church. This is upstairs. Okay? So. What did you get?
I got a 10.
You got a 10? You got a 10?
I got a 10.
That's not a fucking the right dice. Oh, roll a d20.
Oh, this one?
Yes.
This one?
I got a 1.
18.
11.
I got 18.
Aecilius got his face stuck in a cobweb.
Spider egg in my mouth.
What if you're like breaking your mouth?
Alright, who got the highest?
Kevin, I think you got 18.
I got 11 minus, I got 13 minus 2.
Alright, just let me make some notes of that real quick.
Hey, I'm gonna get some hot dogs. Well, this is happening. Anyone want some water?
You get a plus 3, so that's like 20 something. I'm good, thank you.
Oh, wait, I get a plus.
You got 11, right? You rolled 11 or you got 11?
I rolled 13 minus 2.
Okay.
So
I rolled a 10.
I got a 2.
Is it, what is it? What's
it's
the plus?
7, I'm going last. I know that.
Huh?
Is it, what is
it's
it?
Plus your initiative.
Which is?
It's fucking right next to your armor class.
Oh. 3, so 13.
13, what'd you get? You got 2. You don't matter. It's 13.
18, 11, 13.
Yep.
Second
initiative.
It's on again.
What?
It's on.
It's on again.
Okay.
The big one's on.
Good.
Live.
Turn it on.
I thought it was on.
Hold on. No, it has to back up data.
Okay.
Okay, we'll turn it on during the soul mass. You guys just go on as normal.
Keep going.
Well, we're ready for Andy.
Yeah, we also gotta wait for Andy.
Well, we're just telling you what the plan is.
What's going on?
We're figuring out initiative.
Okay. And it's only one guy, right?
It's his one guy, as far as you know.
that's probably what's gonna happen. Oh, this dude's getting a gold barrel to the face.
This is like the cell.
I'm like excited, man. Or whatever.
It's not in a cell. It's unrestrained. It's unrestrained. Pretty sure the only thing keeping him not.
Wait, Kevin, you're not there, right?
Why did we follow the priest down here? Why are we even in the basement?
Kevin is upstairs.
And we're all down.
Where are you?
I'm assuming I have a face down on
here.
All right. The spider will represent Doru.
When that thing's ready.
Dormammu.
The priest will be represented by this little triceratops.
For sure, buddy.
This can be Ismark and the Adina.
I'm trying to figure out.
All right. If I should. The one that Noah is standing on will be the stairs.
Before this happens, can I call a Krog?
No, that needs to be his battle cry. Alright,
well, I'm on top of stairs.
No, you have to, where are you going
now? No, I'm just on the stairs like that, before I step on
them. Alright, well, Dory goes first because it was his surprise thing, and he, like, pretty much bolts upstairs, and, like, tries to get past you, and he manages to get to the
Kevin,
most of the way to the stairs.
I'm gonna use the coffin to slow him down.
You can kick the guy down. He's like, nope.
Do you want to hit him with the coffin?
Yes,
no.
You can.
No. Hit him with the coffin.
It's closed. The body wouldn't fall out.
Oh my god, do it.
Coffin,
do
it. Do it.
I'll do it.
Wait. Is Mark in the...
No, who cares?
Really
you know, who cares? He's not taking us anyways.
Okay.
Hold on.
Okay,
let's see if there's something I can compare it to use stats for.
Would that be like a great name?
Let me look.
Or a log.
Damn it.
Or just a fucking tree at this point.
If this works. If only you had
the fucking great part is that unless he completely fucks it, he'll probably hit him.
You need to get, like,
I'm gonna enjoy this.
I will allow you to use the stats of a great club.
Yes!
Oh god! Kevin, you literally can barely. You can't fuck this up.
Roll an attack roll.
Don't fuck
Which
this up.
Attack roll?
D20.
D20 is your go to. D20 is life. Okay. 20
is
life.
Come on, little man.
16!
16.
Oh yeah.
Good.
He's good.
He hit him. I was gonna say barely, and then I remembered he gets all the bonuses in the world ever. So yeah, you could not miss. Like you swing, and like this guy, he's running. She's like, ah, mother! I'm just, you bring this coffin around it. roll a d8 for damage.
D8? Okay. That's a diamond one.
Yeah, roll a d8 for damage
for me.
Yeah.
Five.
Plus your strength.
Ten.
You knock him down the stairs, just knock him back down.
You know what? I think he might.
He tumbles down the stairs.
Yeah, he did not see this coming. And Irina and Ismark give you like his horrified like.
Tell him why! Tell him why you did it! Tell him why you did it!
It was the only thing I had in my hands.
That's not true. You have your battle axe.
Is my camera still on? Okay. Yes, okay.
You have your axe in your hand.
Yeah, you could have reached for an axe. He could have reached for a hand axe. He went for the coffin.
It worked! Can't deny. I like how he's upside down.
Kevin, oh, God. He's our fucking tank.
Okay, Ashton.
Yeah.
It is now your turn.
So the dude just tumbled down. He's like, what is he like, just on the ground?
He hasn't been knocked prone, but he's like, he's on his hands.
Are we trying?
You could probably make a bolt for it any second.
Are we trying to kill the guy or knock him out?
Let's knock him out. I think he might.
Can we knock him out?
If you melee attack him, then it counts as knocking out.
Okay.
Yeah, you can choose to knock someone out if you do melee.
Okay, I guess I'll just melee him then.
Gosberg does the old traditional Gosberg thing of take him alive!
Alright, I'll just melee him.
I'm a merciful person, okay?
I'll keep my weapons holstered.
Well, you can try to use your weapon to like stun him and like pin him down.
Oh, we got some cocks.
Chickens!
Oh, cool chicken.
I know.
Oh, that's pretty good.
All right, melee attack. There it is. 13 plus my strength, right? Or
yeah, 13 plus your strength. Did you using your short swords?
No, I'm just gonna.
You're just gonna hit him.
Well, I mean, can I bunt him with my use the bunt of my sword?
What are you trying to do here?
Knock him out. I don't
like,
kill
just
him.
Make an attack roll.
Okay, yeah.
For fuck's sake. For like, sure. Are you using your sword or are you not?
Sure, why not? But I don't want to like kill him.
I need to know whether you're using your sword. Are you using your sword?
Just bump him with the bottom of
the
sword.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Can I bump him?
If you attack him, it can be a knockout. Like,
okay.
I'm just working out whether you're using your goddamn sword or not.
I'll use my sword. So 13 plus my strength is 16.
All right, that's a hit.
Okay, cool.
Roll for damage.
That's a d6, correct? Yes.
Does it say?
Oh no, my sword. Yeah.
Not my sword. What does it say on your swords?
My swords, yeah, are d6.
All right, good. Good.
And I land a 5.
A whopping 5 plus your strength.
8.
You do 8 points of damage. His head comes off.
No. Like, son of a bitch.
No, he gets hit and he's like, ah!
Oh, father!
Father, I'm coming!
Okay. I'm stuck!
No, the first thing was Doru going first, so now he goes again. And he tried. Who the hell put him? That was not right.
Because you had him.
I used stupid Wobbuffet instead of the spider.
No, you used the spider.
You used the spider for Doru.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
exactly.
He tumbled down the stairs.
He tumbled down the stairs. And you had
I did not say he went all the way down the stairs.
Oh, that makes no sense. How did he shoot him?
He went there. Krog was up there. We didn't move him yet.
Okay.
But fine, I bumped him in the back of his head then.
He tries to get back up to the top of the stairs, basically. Someone put him up by Krog. All the while screaming, Father, help me!
Okay. Hit him again!
Doru is in the corner, like, oh. Now it is Gosberg's turn. Gosberg, hold!
Shoot him in the back.
I'm sorry.
How wounded is he, by the way? Does it look like he's just gonna die in like
8 damage, right?
It looks like he's about to fall at any moment.
No, he does not. In fact, oh shit.
What?
One moment. Thank you for reminding me.
He gets regeneration. Please tell me he doesn't.
Yeah, he get, you see the wound that Ashton just inflicted heal right up.
Guys, he has regeneration.
But that bashing damage that Kron did is forever.
Okay, I'm gonna... He's still trying to rush out, right?
He is still trying to get out.
I'm gonna... I wanna see if it's possible for me to, tackle him.
You could grapple him if you wanted to.
Grapple him and then use my weight to, like, try to...
Reminder, I'm on the stairs, so everybody's, like, just bumping into me.
Well, you're not that hefty, so just for passing.
Okay, yeah, I'd say you could try to grapple him. Let me see if you have to make an actual... I think you have to make a strength check against him.
Okay.
So roll a d20, and it'll be a contested strength check.
Okay, guys, got 17 strength. Let's not fuck this up.
Nine plus 3, so 12. Let me see if grappling is what I think it is, real quick.
Either that or javelin him in the back.
Yeah, you have to use your attack. Okay. So you run up to it, and then you also, you could add your athletics modifier.
That's 5.
If so that's not already eight. Strength, I think.
That's 8 plus 9.
Alright. So, plus 9?
Yeah.
So 5 plus 9. Just 5.
Oh, 5 plus 9. No, strength plus athletic.
Is it strength? I guess, yeah. Both of those.
Okay, let's
say
that's 8.
Or 9.
So that's 9 plus
8. Till I figure
so
out.
So 17.
How right. Okay. That's pretty fucking good. Let's see what Doru can do without... Oh, well. Yeah, you grapple him. I don't even need to look up what the fucking modifiers are for that shit. That was a 4.
Yeah,
Gosberg just runs up the stairs and... Doru, he's just kind of looking at Krog holding this coffin aloft. And while he's distracted, Gosberg leaps up behind him and grabs
him. Are we talking like a WWE thing where like people like...
I don't grab him like that, so I just knock him to the ground.
Yeah, you are on top of him.
I'm using the weight of my armor in order to hold him down, guys.
Good job, we're actually using really good rolls.
Thank you.
we're not rolling ones.
We're not fucking up this time.
Yeah. What are you saying? Where's the wood?
As you're on him, you can feel your holy symbol, your locket, digging into him a little bit, and it's like, and you can kind of hear, like he does not like this.
Oh!
It's like, I burn, father!
Oh, God, my locket!
Aeselius!
I can't do
anything. Our mage!
Can't do anything without killing him.
Force push him.
You have a quarterstaff.
I have a quarterstaff.
You could bonk him on.
Okay. While you're sitting on top of him, I'm gonna just
break his jaw.
Do you want to use your magician's wand or?
Because
it can become a.
I'll use that one.
Break his jaw.
You honestly might as well throw out the regular quarterstaff.
Yeah.
It's shit compared to the magician's wand.
I should have sold it.
I'm sure we'll come across a source.
People are shooting each other already.
All right. I'm just smash it right in the face.
Alright, cool. Roll an attack roll.
Did you see that?
3.
I would say you might have advantage because he has him grappled.
He rolled a 3.
He like hits
roll again!
Spear. Roll again. 10. Plus 0.
Please don't pull a scram.
Plus your strength.
0.
You have strength at all? No? Okay. Yeah, somehow, even though that this dude is pinned down, you're just kind of like, and you like bring your club down, but you just kind of hit the stairs.
No, imagine he brings it down when it hits me by accident.
Yeah, it on bringing it up, it kind of bounces off Gosberg's armor, and he kind of gives you a look.
Damn it, scrap by me!
I'm gonna miss Scrump until we see him again. All right. It is now Krog's turn.
Okay. Should I use the old man again?
Krog.
Yes.
No more.
Oh God.
Do it.
Okay. You could not wedge this coffin into the stairway. It's a trap door.
Okay.
You would have to like fucking do some
you'd have
shit.
To force it
There's
in.
Not enough room. There's not enough room.
Okay, so I just use my bottom of my hand axe to knock him out.
So. You do not. Okay, we don't need to bottom things. Like, okay. If you can just attack normally. We don't
okay.
Need to,
okay.
I mean, I will bottom it if that's the actual thing that knocks him out.
I'll use my scimitar.
You're using your scimitar instead of your hand axe?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, d20 first?
Yes.
D20. Roll a d20. Add your strength modifier and your proficiency bonus.
I got an 8.
Plus 5. 15.
Wait, which one?
Your strength plus your...
five.
So plus seven. Every attack you make, with that's a melee attack, you get +7.
So that's 15.
Okay.
That is barely a hit.
Okay.
Roll for damage.
6. 11.
Jesus Christ. You're fucking Krog.
Fucking dude. Oh, man.
Oh, man. I'm gonna be sad if he dies.
I'll do every.
That was the scimitar myself. Too? Like 1d6?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Sorry, my fault. That was my bad.
Alrighty then. It is Ashton's turn again.
Okay.
Wait, I didn't knock him out.
No, you didn't knock him out. He's still like, he's under Gosberg, like, Father! They're hurting me!
I guess I'll just run up the stairs and then just hit him again with my sword.
Alright, as you do that, Donovich, he's like, please, he's my son! He's my only son!
I know, we're not trying to kill him, we're trying to, you know, knock him out.
We're trying to subdue him.
Subdue him, yes.
Okay, I guess that's fine.
Like, yeah, okay, I guess it works. Okay, so I ran upstairs and then I run up the stairs, swords in hand, and I... 13. 10 plus 3, 13.
Nah.
And I hit the wall.
And you did not calculate the fact that you are in a small hallway with a staircase, and you reached back to do this awesome hit, and then ding!
It's like the cartoon thing, like,
Yoru is gonna attempt to get the hell out of that grapple.
He gets out.
Oh, yes, God. You have to roll two. It is contested.
Roll again.
Vampire spawn get a plus what? Two. What is he doing?
I got two.
She's out. Also good for you.
Let me see. Alright, what did you get?
I got two.
He got 10.
Oh, but also got proficiency bonus.
Two so, athletics?
8.
He got 10.
I also have 10.
You also got 10?
Yeah, because 2 plus 8.
What the hell did we do if there's a tie?
Roll again.
No, we did not roll again. I'm checking the book. I realize this is a bad show, but checking the book.
Yes, I'm stuck. It'll be 100% your fault.
I should have. Okay, I flipped right to the grapple page. It did not. Shit, it doesn't say what to do if there's a tie.
Just roll again.
Just roll again.
Alright, roll it again.
5.
Yeah, you're both squeaking about. Oh.
I got 8. That's a 12.
That was a 3.
That was a 3. That bounced off my cup. That was a 3.
So I win either way.
So you win either way, yeah.
Alright, y'all, Mike.
Oh, yeah, mate.
Alright, he almost gets away and you're on him again. Like, no.
Nope. I kind of just like.
Father, help me, please! He's crushing me!
Father, help me! He's killing me with love!
You also see him regenerate the health, the wound from the scimitar most of the way.
Tiny chicken.
Okay,
Icelius next?
Your turn.
No,
yes.
Oh, cool.
So I got
Gosberg Holtz!
I don't think I could tell. I'm gonna just put my locket around him.
You gonna put your locket on him?
Yeah.
On him?
Yeah. Just like put it around
okay.
him. Okay. You have to with that.
This is gonna suck if he escapes, but okay.
Hey.
You put it around his neck and you manage to do it and like he's like, ah no! It burns.
Okay.
Alright.
Do I have to roll for that?
Nah.
Okay, so I'm gonna put my locket around him. Do I still have to take another action?
I think since you're grappling him, that's what you're doing, unless you want to let go and try to hit him.
I'm gonna keep grappling him.
Keep grappling. Okay.
Okay.
Aecilius!
I'm gonna try to hit him again with the staff.
Okay, hit him again with a quarter staff attack.
All this is happening in like
17.
One stairway.
That's a hit.
All this is happening
roll
for
in damage.
One stairway. How does this work?
20.
No!
No,
oh.
No, that's not the one you
roll. One time you roll a perfect 20. And
four.
What's
what
strength?
Is? Don't you roll a d8 for damage?
Oh.
Quarter staff. It says it right there. I put it on
no,
your equipment.
D6.
What does it say for his equipment?
Quarter staff is D8.
Yeah.
Roll a D8.
Yeah.
Which
is diamond. Okay.
Roll.
Three.
Isn't that plus
three?
Zero.
So zero.
That's
30,
man.
that's something.
No,
it's
okay.
Alright. You bonk him on the head. And he's like, ah!
Regenerate
and he kinda like, he kinda bares his fangs at you. Krong!
Alright, tank, finish it off.
I don't think we're gonna be able to knock him out.
Help me bring him down!
Dude, what, just fucking curb stomp his face in there, dude. You can fucking kill him.
Help me bring him
we
down!
We have rope.
Oh, yeah,
we have rope.
You guys all have rope, yeah.
Yeah,
we got rope for days.
You
wow, how
okay,
dumb
I'll
is that?
Rope.
Oh, we're doing all this shit. You have rope.
Krog reaches into his explorer's pack. Remembering that he has rope, he pulls it off the side. It's actually at hand. It's not in the pack. It's on the side of the pack. So you have about 50 feet of rope. How much do you want to use?
How much? I don't know. How much? Let's say, I don't know. Let's say 2 feet is one loop.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are we hanging the dude? Like,
no, we're just tied down.
Okay. Okay, so let's say I'm,
all right,
5 feet, 5 loops?
No,
yeah.
No, he's strong. He's a
vampire. Okay,
sure.
You can cut through
it. So how much feet? 50 feet?
Yeah, you have 50 feet of rope.
Okay, so 20 feet? Yeah, okay, 20 feet. 20 feet
of rope. You can use 20 feet of rope to tie up one dude. That seems excessive.
He's a vampire.
How much are you tying? Is he gonna be like, is he gonna be a fucking
what
rope
do you recommend,
cocoon?
What do you recommend?
Or are you...
No, no, it's like, think about like, it's like I'm you
no
tie
recommendation.
Him up once. It's like you just tie him up once.
Like, are you tying him all the way around
yes,
his body?
Yeah,
oh
yeah,
God, okay.
No, just 10 feet.
Because I figured you guys are gonna be like doing his hell,
no.
But
like,
you're actually
like
you're cocooning this motherfucker.
I'm cocooning this motherfucker.
Okay, I just wanted to know. I need clarification.
Tuning this motherfucker!
What
so he can better
no,
work
what 15 rope.
Okay,
15.
He's gonna metamorphosize into a beautiful ass
he's
butterfly!
Platypus!
If you guys are gonna do this, then I'm gonna have to have. Oh god, this is gonna require some skill checks on your parts. I need you both to make athletics checks if you're gonna let him try to do this. Try and keep Doru restrained.
Seven. Seven plus what?
Well, you
which one is
try
it?
To tie him up.
Seven. Dexterity.
Dexterity? Three.
That's
so 10. Wait, athletics? Isn't that strength?
You do athletics, you do dex.
Oh, okay.
I will say
20!
Woo! Oh yeah, this guy is held down.
Whatever, he's held down anyways.
Alright, he
got
is 10. Tied up. That was just to see... If you even could tie him up. So roll for me to see how well you actually tie him up. Let me see if there's any skills.
13
plus what?
Dexterity?
Dexterity?
16.
So 16.
I didn't say that. I don't know what could help. Maybe sleight of hand. Don't pardon. Not. Yeah, it seems like he's fairly well tied up. I think you got him.
You can't really get out.
No, he seems to be stuck. He's like, Fana, help me!
Okay.
Gag him while you're at it.
This is a church, not a bonfire! Not a bonfire!
Not like
club.
That, you filthy-minded old fool.
Not a brothel?
Doru walks up and he puts his hands on him. My son!
I kind of just use my warhammer and kind of just like push the guy off.
Yeah, you pushing. Yeah, okay.
Pushing the old man off the well, older man off his son. He's like, he's not your son anymore. He's a minor son.
But I want to help him.
You shall have that help, but not now. He must be restrained properly, otherwise he might escape again.
Yes. Yes, of course.
What the hell are you guys doing?
It's cold!
Okay, so, I'm sorry guys, this has been longer than I thought it would. So, you gonna like toss him back in the basement?
I wanna take off my locket first.
Oh yeah, you take your locket off him, you gotta struggle, and at that moment the knot is broken! No, you get your locket off him, and
kick him down the stairs.
He's already down the stairs, basically. No, okay, no. Yeah, you kick him down the stairs.
Father, I'm that kicking with the multiple thousand donkeys.
Did you say donkeys?
Yes, he kicked him with the force of a thousand donkeys. That's Krog.
Okay.
Sure. Okay, so you guys go back upstairs, right? Yeah. I'm assuming you're not sticking around.
No.
When you get back up there, Ismark, he kind of shoots you a dirty look like, do not use my father's coffin as a weapon again.
Well, there goes our payment.
I know, right? Well,
are you going to pay us anyway?
No.
Yes.
He said he was going to pay us.
Oh. It's probably going to be deducted from your account now.
Deduct him.
I know, right?
He's just kind of staring at you while you are. Can we get down to business now?
Yes.
We are here for a reason.
Yes, yes.
All right.
We immediately wanted to see what was that noise. Turns out that man had a vampire underneath the church.
Yes, we figured this.
Thanks, buddy. Oh, yeah, actually.
All right, so you guys taking the body out to the cemetery?
Yeah, uh-huh. Sure.
All right, cool.
You guys
thank
want
goodness
me?
You didn't try to kill him or knock him out completely, because that would have taken fucking
huh?
forever.
Right.
Here, I don't trust a single thing.
A fence of wrought iron
thank you.
With a rusty gate encloses a rectangular
that's
block
mine.
Of land behind a dilapidated church. Tightly packed gravestones, shrouded by fog, bear the names of souls long past. All seems quiet. And Frog puts down the coffin all by himself.
This is a goddamn super mutant.
Laying it in a hole. Sorry, but that was already open pretty much. I think they just kind of prepare for that in Barovia, you know? Someone's gonna die.
They just have empty holes to dig up.
Yeah.
Every time
what if someone falls in? Well, there you go. That's the person that died.
The priest, Donovich, he starts doing some priestly, some burial rites. Like he seems to be praying to the Morning Lord. It's like, please let this man pass. Into the light that is your glory. Roll some perception checks for me, boys.
9.
14.
8.
12. Is this plus anything
plus
or
two,
no?
So 14.
Plus your perception.
That's right. 9.
So plus wisdom, or whatever you have for perception.
I got 14.
Well, for my perception, I have plus 2, so like 11.
What
yeah,
11.
That?
Wisdom?
Perception's like right there.
You got minus 1 to perception somehow. 14.
I got 14.
Alright. 12, yeah.
Alright, Gosberg. Everyone else is just kind of standing there like, you know.
Morning.
Around the grave. You notice out of the corner of your eye there's some movement in the trees. Around the cemetery.
It's the end.
He's having more flashbacks.
They're coming out the tree. No! The trees! They're alive!
There's not a lot of trees, but you did see something in the mists for a second.
Okay. I grabbed the hilt of the handle of my warhammer just in case, and I just tap Ashton.
Camera problem.
Oh.
Low battery. Went out.
Went out.
I hate this thing. Okay, well, good thing we've got Meg here.
I guess we're wrapping up, so.
Yeah, we are wrapping up. Okay, so.
Very strong, guys.
I just kind of tap that Ashton. And I kind of just point towards the tree line as to not interrupt the ceremony.
What do you guys think?
Okay, they're silly.
As soon as he says that, you see. Almost, like, because the mists are so thick, these things just step out of the mist.
Zombies.
Wolves.
Ah, shit.
Oh, wolves are bad.
Again. Dire wolves, which means some of them are huge.
Are they all dire wolves, or just, like,
no, sure. There's a lot of wolves, and there's a few dire wolves
oh, so
mixed in.
Okay.
And they are stepping towards you. Get your goddamn character sheet while I'm describing this scene. Dire wolves, bloodthirsty wolves, all stepping slowly around you, surrounding.
Wait, where are we? We're the graveyard. We're outside the graveyard, right?
Yeah.
Right here. Okay, so.
Okay. While they're all stepping out, I shout out.
Curiosity. Aecilius, out of the corner of your eye in the distance when you look and see these wolves.
Who's this?
That's a girl.
I'm gonna slap the shit out of you, keep it around me.
Sorry.
Do you want Tiamat to come from the sky? The mother of all evil dragons?
Keep talking.
Aecilius, you notice just past these wolves, just for a second, you see the silhouette of a man.
Do I know this man?
No, you do not know this man.
Did I detect magic?
It was a silhouette. You did not know.
Okay.
Wolves are completely surrounding you.
Can I do a perception check to see what he looks like?
Roll a perception check. See if you can see him.
12.
How well you can see him. Plus what?
Plus 3. 15.
15? He looks to be wearing a cape, and he seems like he has some noble features, but you can't tell too much. The mists are very thick.
I cry out, we are being assailed into the church! And I kind of just like grab, get some, Ismark and Aecilia, and I kind of just...
Aecilius.
Or whatever.
Irina!
Sorry! I am bad with names!
Bad with names!
I mean...
Did you take an arrow to the skull as well?
I have been hit in the head more times than you can count, demon!
He turns around and is like, what?
As you're arguing, are now blocking the entrance.
See what you've done!
And they start jumping over the... A few of them have actually jumped over the gates.
Weapons out,
of
boys.
The cemetery.
Okay. Question, do I have the man?
No,
he is on the ground. You do not have the coffin anymore.
Alms.
It is in a hole.
That's alms, man.
Dig it out.
The Krog is frantically like digging. It's like a dog. He's like a dog like digging out there.
That's alms, man. Circle formation.
Aecilius, you also noticed that Irina was looking at the exact same spot as you were. And she is horrified.
Is it alive? Okay.
She knows something.
I'm pretty sure we're all gonna draw our weapons out of this.
You
place.
All draw your weapons.
Atoms, men! Defensive formations!
Finally get to use my fucking arrows at this, point.
Spell it out for me with the miniatures real quick. Like, how are you guys standing?
Can I
are we gonna circle?
Knock it away. Knock it all away. But the church is gone.
Okay.
Tiamat blew it up.
Here's the buried body.
The what?
No.
Because we're gonna have the funeral.
Put them all in the center right here for fuck's sake.
Okay.
Everybody, let's say,
funeral's right here.
Let's say we're, like,
Are you, like, standing in a circle, like, back to back? What are you doing?
Kind
of
like this.
Yeah, we're all circled around it, but we're now turned around, like, watching the wolves. All
right, like, put Irina here in the middle. She'll be that. This will be Ismark.
She's next to me.
Ismark. That's the priest. He's standing by the grave. Ismark also draws his longsword, and he's, like, ready. And these wolves are just like kind of slowly creeping towards you.
And at that moment, 21, including the golden arrow.
At that moment, a raven flies down.
Is he quoting this?
A raven flies down and lands on a nearby gravestone. This one, right there.
Say this is the raven.
He goes, ah! And this raven is just sitting there, and he's looking. The direction this raven is looking, Aecilius, you notice since you're looking, like, right fucking at the raven.
You're like, hey.
You're right there. I didn't notice that.
Also saluting.
This raven is looking, like, right where you saw that silhouette of a man.
The raven's looking.
The raven, yes. The raven that just landed there. And now all the wolves sort of start to back off. Until eventually, like, the few that got inside the gates jump over, and they disappear into the mists.
New wolves keep like showing up and then like vanishing.
And that's where we'll stop for today.
Oh. I was not ready for a badass battle too.
You shall die in glory!
Hey, you die anyway.
Wolf flashbacks, the elves are attacking! He watched the trees. The yes will save us. All right.
So, what do you guys think?
Oh, yeah, that was pretty awesome.
You shut down?
You're the shit.
Yeah. You shut down?
All right. We will see you guys next time with more Roll for Adventure. I've been your DM. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Get inside. It's fucking freezing.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
Hey, so tactic. So-